So yesterday we have seen like how to install SQL Server 2005 on Windows Server 2008 R2, and we have also seen some topics like some discussion. We have made some discussions on what is an edition, what is a default instance, what is named instance, how many default instance we can install on SQL Server, total how many instances we can install on SQL Server, how many named instances we can install. What is a named instance? What is the naming conventions to put the name? What are the conditions? Means, what is an instance? Instance is nothing but just a brief discussion about yesterday's class, and I'll jump to the tomorrow's discussion. Just a brief discussion. So, what is an instance? What are the basic requirements to install SQL Server 2005? We have at least Windows Server 2000 with SP4. Or else we can install SQL Server 2005 on Windows Server 2003 with SP1. Or else we can install SQL Server 2005 on Windows Server 2008 RTM. Or else we can install SQL Server Windows Server 2008 R2. And so what are the software requirements and hardware requirements? Hardware requirements is like minimum 1 GB RAM. We should be have the minimum 1 GB RAM and 2 GB storage minimum. And one CPU is compulsory. These are the hardware requirements. And what are the software requirements? We should have .NET Framework 2.0 and we should have Windows Installer 3.1. So how to check Windows Installer is there or not? What version of Windows Installer is there in my server? How to check? So we can check by using MSI EXEC. Give me a minute. So, how to check? We have Windows installer. Which version of Windows installer is there in our computer? We can check by using MSI EXEC. Go to run and type MSI EXEC, then you can able to find the version of the Windows installer. And of course, we have SQL Server 2005 software. So these are the basic hardware and software requirements. So you know about RDP. What is RDP? Means remote desktop. So installing SQL Server. It will start with YOLA. YOLA screen is nothing but end user license agreement. The first setup screen which you are seeing is a YOLA screen. That is called end user license agreement. Once you click on the setup file, you can able to see one setup file. On that you can see some YOLA. Like that you will click like I will accept license terms. I will accept SQL Server license terms. You will check, right? That screen we will call it as YOLA screen. YOLA means end user license agreement. It's just a license screen. That's it. So next we have discussed about instance. What is an instance? Instance is a SQL Server software copy. That's it. So we can install up to 50 software copies of SQL Server on Windows Server. So in the 50 instances, one is like default instance and another one is like named instance. Functionality wise, there is no difference between default instance and named instance. Just default instance will take the computer name as a server name, SQL Server name. Named instance, we have to externally provide the name. So what are the conditions if you want to put any name to the SQL Server? So you have some conditions like it will not accept more than 16 characters. It will not accept more than 16 characters. And one more condition is like it will not accept any special characters except dollar and underscore. Except dollar and underscore. Instance name have to start with the alphabet only. So instance name have to start with alphabet. It cannot start with numbers. Spaces are not allowed in the instance name. Instance name will be like, if default instance will take the name of the computer, how to check the computer name? How to check computer name? I told you like two ways we can check the computer name. What is the command prompt? How can we check the computer name in command prompt? Just open command prompt and type host name. And then you can able to find the computer name. And another way is like go to my computer, go to properties, you can able to see computer name. So like that you can able to find the computer name. So instance have to start with the alphabet, and spaces are not allowed in the instance name. Instance name will be, so default instance will take the computer name, and named instance, what will be the named instance name? Named instance name will be like computer name backslash instance name. So it will be like this, computer name backslash instance name, the named instance name. Even though if you will put name for this area only, these all rules will apply for that area only. So you can't change the computer name. You can change the computer name. So generally in the organization we'll never change the computer name. So that is the work of Windows server, Windows admin team. So even though if you change the computer name, again we have to change our server name also. Why? Because our server name includes computer name. So if you didn't change the computer name, if you didn't change our SQL server name, then it will show the old name. Even though if you restart the server, it will show the old name only. It will not automatically fetch the computer name, or it will not automatically rename the by fetching the computer name. So we have to manually change the SQL server name also. So these are rules. This instance name will contain conditions something like, it has to follow all the above conditions. So generally instance name, if it is a named instance, the name of the SQL server will be like a computer name slash backslash instance name. Like this, it will be, if my instance name, I put the instance name as ABC, then what is the SQL server full name? Windows computer name. This is all Windows name, meaning computer name backslash instance name. Next, we have discussed about service account. What is a service account? So what is a service account? It is an account which will help to run a service, as I already discussed it, right? What is the use of service account? Means if the SQL server, if the database engine wants to read the data or write the data to the disk, it has some permissions. So we will not give direct permissions to the service. On behalf of service, one account, the service will log in on one account, which will help as a server, which will help as a agent, or which will help as a worker to the service, So generally we will give all the permissions to the service account. That account is called a service account. So like that, service account will help. It is an account which will help to run a service account. We have two types of service accounts. One is like inbuilt service accounts. So those who are coming with the computer by default is called inbuilt service accounts. And we can also, give me a minute. So we have two types of service accounts: inbuilt service accounts, customized service accounts, or user defined service accounts. We will call it as a user defined service accounts. So what are inbuilt service accounts? Inbuilt service accounts are the default accounts that are coming by default with the server. What are user defined service accounts? User defined service accounts are, we will manually create one user, and we will give the username as a service account to the service, to any service. So generally if you install SQL server, how many services will come? If you install any SQL server, how many services will come? So we can able to see, we will see now how many services will come once we have installed SQL server. So I am connecting to the virtual server. How can I connect to the virtual server? By using remote RDP. RDP, how will you do RDP? Open, run in your local laptop, type MSTSC, then you can able to see one pop-up which will ask for IP address of the server which we want to connect. Just give the IP address, then just press connect button. Then it will ask for administrator password of that particular server which we are connecting. Give the password, click yes, then you can able to connect to the virtual server from local. So now how to check how many services came while installing SQL Server? How to check the services? Directly go to services.msc. You can see how many, yesterday we have installed SQL Server 2005, right? We can see how many services are there in the services.msc, or else we can check in another way. I'll tell you that way also. So go to services.msc, expand this one, just click S so that you can able to see SQL services. So see, this many services came once you have installed SQL Server. What are the services? This is the main service, SQL Server, MS SQL Server. See, I'll tell you the difference between default instance and named instance now. Not a big difference, a small difference. If you install default instance, what I told you, default instance will take the computer name as its server name, right? So generally, what will be the server name, SQL Server name? If the computer name is like ABC, then SQL Server name is also like ABC. So like that. See, this name will help to identify the server. That's it. The services, if we have installed SQL Server default instance, the services will be named. Named as MS SQL Server. You can't see the name, computer name here. So if you found any service with MS SQL Server in the brackets, then you can able to say that is a default instance. See here, this is a main service for the SQL Server. SQL Server, the service name is like SQL Server brackets MS SQL Server. This represents the name of the instance. Then you have to ask, like you told that if you install default instance, yesterday I installed default instance only. Then you told that if you install default instance, it should take computer name. But in the services, in the configuration manager, I'll tell you the configuration manager later. In the services, it will not show you the computer name. If we install SQL Server in the SSMS, what is that? SQL Server Management Studio, which is a tool to connect to the database engine. There only it will show the name of the SQL Server name as a computer name. Remaining in any remaining area like services.msc, or else configuration manager, or else in our instance root directory, or else in any other field, it will show like MS SQL Server. It will not show with computer name. So by seeing this name, you have to say that this service belongs to default instance. So you understand, right? So in services.ms, in the configuration under instance directory, instance root directory, the name is like MS SQL Server. If we install named instance, the service name will be like, if my SQL Server name is like ABC, in the brackets you are able to see SQL Server brackets ABC. So that is a main service which is belongs to ABC instance. See, for example, I have three instances in my server. In my server, say for example, one is default instance and another one is like, another two is like named instances. So my computer name is like ABC, see for example, and named instance I gave like XYZ. So generally, what is the name of the SQL Server name for named instance? ABC. It will start with computer name slash XYZ, right? What is the name of SQL Server if it is a default instance? Just ABC. This name you can see in SQL Server Management Studio. SSMS, SQL Server Management Studio. So in remaining parts, if it is a default instance, you can see services like SQL Server, which is a main service, and the name you can find like MS SQL Server. So which represents the main service belongs to default instance. And remaining for every product, I told you na, if you install one product, if you install one software copy, that is an instance. We will call it as a instance. If you install one software copy, if it is a default instance, you can able to see the service name, main service name, like this with this name. If you install three instances, of course we can install one default instance only. Remaining two should be named instances. Then there also one main service will come. That is like SQL Server. If the name instance, the name of this second SQL Server is like BBC, so you can able to main service of the BBC like this. You have installed one more server, right? Like the name is, we have already discussed, like XYZ. So you can find multiple main services with the name. So if it is a named instance, it will directly show in the brackets. It will show it. This name will never change. This name will be same. This name will be same. This name will change in the brackets. This name will be change. If it reflects only MS SQL Server, which will we have to understand like it's a service which is belongs to default instance. If it reflects any other name which you gave to the server, then we have to understand like this belongs to named instance. Like that you have to understand. Here also you can able to see MS SQL Server, SQL Server, MS SQL Server. This is the main service. If we stop this service, the server will go down. See here, you can able to see stop, pause, restart. So if you stop this service, the server will go down, which will be risky. And I told you now, six services will come. So you can able to see the six services now. SQL Server, which is a main service. SQL Server Active Directory Helper is one more service. SQL Server Agent, these two are main. Of course, this is also main, but generally you will see daily you will see these two services in SSMS. So SQL Server Browser, SQL Server Full Text Search, SQL Server VSS Writer. Total how many? 1 2 3 4 5 6 7, right? But six services will, this is by default, it will be there. So you can able to see 1 2 3 4 5, okay, six only. Yes, six. So six services will come once you have installed SQL Server. So like that you can able to identify the services. In a what is the other way to see the services? We have another tool called Configuration Manager. How to go to Configuration Manager? Generally we will work with Configuration Manager only. DBS will work with Configuration Manager only. If you want to restart the service, if you want to stop the service, if you want to start the service, if you want to change the service account, generally we will go to Configuration Manager only. So how to go to Configuration Manager? Just expand this SQL Server 2005, go to Configuration Tools, then you can able to see one more briefcase here, SQL Server Configuration Manager. You can go like this, or else you can go by using a shortcut. What is the shortcut for that? I'll tell you. So once it's opened, I'll tell you the shortcut. So SQL, what is the SQL Server Configuration Manager contains? SQL Server Configuration Manager is a separate tool which will help to see the services and something like network type of protocols. We can able to see everything here. See here, we can able to see especially SQL Server services only. There we can able to see in the services.msc, as it is a Windows tool, we can able to see all the services which we have installed. All, if we install more softwares, if we install the softwares in the Windows server, we can able to see all the services which belongs to remaining softwares also in the services.msc. But in the configuration, if you go to services, we can able to see only SQL Server related services only. You can able to see remaining, you can in services.msc you can able to see like six services, right? Here you can able to see only four. If you have installed SSMS, if you have installed that reporting services, analysis services, you can able to see more services here. But by default you can able to see four services here. So if you want to start or stop any service, you can check here, what is the state of the service? It's running. What is the start mode? It's automatic. What is meant by start mode? I'll tell you. So login as, this login as is called as service account. So my service is logged on as local system service account, means it is using local system service account, which is a default service account. So like that we can able to see. So here also you can able to see, right, SQL server in brackets MS SQL server, which will represents this is a, this belongs to a default instance service. So you can able to see browser, you can able to see MS SQL server. So yesterday you have seen, right, my local instance is showing in virtual machine while connecting to the SQL server. How will you open SSMS? How will you open Management Studio? We can open two ways, like go to start, click on this icon, SQL Server Management Studio, or else what is the shortcut for that? We have especially two shortcuts to open SQL Server Management Studio. So go to all programs, open SSMS, like SQL Server Management Studio, or else what is the shortcut for that? If it is a SQL Server 2005, if it is at SQL Server 2005, the shortcut is like SQL WB. If it is SQL Server 2008 till up to now, means SQL Server 2017. What is the shortcut for that? SSMS. Where you will apply the shortcut? Just cancel. I am closing the SSMS Management Studio. I am opening with a shortcut. So open run, then type SQL WB. Why? Because I have installed SQL Server 2005 in my virtual machine. That's why I am using SQL Server 2005 shortcut. Just type, press enter, then you can able to see this type of window, this which is called a connection server window. So if you able to type the Windows server, I mean SQL Server name, then you can able to type, or else if you able to select the name, you can able to select the. Here server type remains database engine. We will connect to database engine only. If you want to connect to integration services, reporting services, how can we select? You can select here analysis services, reporting services, SQL Server mobile and integration services. Or if you want to connect, by default we will connect to database engine only. And server name, how will you give the server name? We can give server name in multiple ways. Like we can give the computer name also, or else we can give the dot, or else we can give local, which both dot and local will represent the local admin only. So that's why we are able to connect to the instance. Now if you want to see how many SQL servers are there in my virtual machine, then you can able to see just by clicking browse for more. Here you can able to see, click on network servers in your whole network, it will show in your whole network how many servers are there. It will show here. So how it will show here? If you expand this one, so you can able to see my local SQL server also it is showing here, my local laptop SQL server also it is showing here. Why it is showing? My virtual machine and my local machine are connected to the same Wi-Fi, that's why it is showing. If they are connected to the same Wi-Fi, how it will show? Like it will show by using one service called SQL Server Browser. SQL Server Browser, which will help to show all the servers this service. What we call it as SQL Server Browser. Browser is like nothing but our web browser. This browser is nothing but which will help to show all the servers or connect to all the servers in our whole network. Right now, what is my network? Wi-Fi is my network. My local laptop also connected to my Wi-Fi network, and my virtual machine also connected to my Wi-Fi network. So both are in one network only. That's why it is showing local SQL server also there. So if provided if the service is running. If we stop this service, we'll check now whether I can able to see my local laptop SQL server. So now I stopped browser. So now I'm just trying to see what are the services are there. I just refresh and I check. So once again I will go to local service and network services. Or else give me a minute. Browse for more. Database engine. Go to Windows, sorry, same. Go to the server name. Browser. Go to network. So now you are able to see Jagadish PC. It is not showing two servers. Okay, we'll check now. Generally, if we turn off the browser, SQL Server browser, then you are not able to see all the servers in the network. So which will help like that. In organization also, it will be like in stop mode only. In the organization also, it will be like in stop mode only. So just connect to our local server. Just connect. You can connect like by giving local name, or you can just connect by giving just dot, or you can connect by using computer name as it is a default instance. So it was connected. So like that we can able to connect to the SQL server. And we are discussing about that services, right? So minimize this one. So you can able to see these services, these four services in your configuration manager. What is the shortcut to open configuration manager? What is the shortcut to open configuration manager? So just type Windows R. Any shortcuts will run only. So SQL Server Manager, SQL Server Manager, and version number. Here I have SQL Server 2005. So what is the version number for that? SQL Server 2005. What is the version number for that? What is the major version? 9.0, right? So 9.msc. If we have SQL Server 2008, we have to type like SQL Server Manager 10.msc. Why? Because the version name, if we have what version we have installed in our server, that version number only we have to give as a shortcut. If we have SQL Server 2008 R2, the major number for SQL Server 2008 R2 is like 10 only. So you have to type SQL Server Manager 10.msc. You have SQL Server 2012 in your manager. What is the shortcut to open configuration manager? SQL Server 2011.msc. As 12 has version number 11. 12 has 12, version number of 12 starts with 11. So like that, 12.msc, 13.msc, 14.msc. So for example, in your laptop, in your virtual machine, you have SQL Server 2005, and you have SQL Server 2008, and you have SQL Server 2008 R2, you have SQL Server 2000, for example, comparison. So you have SQL Server 2005 and 2008 in the same machine. So what is the shortcut to open configuration manager? Then don't try to open the configuration manager with lower version number. Means don't try to open the configuration manager with 9.msc. Even though you have SQL Server 2005, don't try to open configuration manager with SQL Server 2005. Just type the highest version which you install in your virtual machine. So now I have 2005 and 2008. Assume that I have only SQL Server 2005 in my machine. Assume that I have 2005 and 2008. Then open configuration manager of 2008. Then you can able to see the lower version services also. Like that, if you have 2005, 8, 12 in the same virtual machine, then open the configuration manager of 12. Then you can able to see SQL Server 2005 services, SQL Server 2008 services, SQL Server 2008 R2 services, if they are installed in your virtual machine, then click OK. SQL Server Manager, it should come right. Okay, I am sorry for that. For SQL Server 2005, no need to provide any numbers. From SQL Server 2008 onwards, you have to provide numbers for shortcut. For SQL Server 2005, no need to provide any numbers. SQL Server, just you have type like SQL Server Manager 11, SQL Server Manager dot msc. That's it. For SQL Server 2008 onwards, you have to give version number here. SQL Server SQL Server Manager 10 dot msc, 11 dot msc, 12 dot msc, like that. You have to give versions. So the same concept will apply, but remember, no need to give any number for SQL Server 2005 to open the configuration manager. So like that, we can able to see the services here. What all things we have to discuss? Yeah, discuss. Give me a minute. So now we are going to discuss like what happened if we install SQL Server in our virtual machine. So what files will come once we have installed? We have yesterday we have also discussed some files, right? What are the files? Like we have discussed some DLLs, RLLs, MSI, MSP, manifest, cab files. So which will help to install SQL Server, which will help to patch the SQL Server in that main files like MSI, MSP. So if you have any question like have you ever faced any issue while installing SQL Server, means you can say like yes sir, I got an error like while installing SQL Server, I got an error like MSI MSP missing. So like that. So how to install even though if you are having issue with MSI MSPs, then I'll tell you later. So we have seen some files yesterday. So now what exactly will happen, what files will come into the server once we have installed SQL Server? So we can see multiple folders in program files. If we install SQL Server, we can see multiple folders in program files. So what we call it as, we'll check now. So if we install SQL Server 2005, we can see like some folders. We can see a name with folder SQL software name. So Microsoft SQL Server, we can see, right? This name is called base directory. So this name is called base directory. If you open this base directory, so if you open this base directory, you can able to see some files which is related to the SQL Server. This directory, C program files Microsoft SQL Server, we can call this as base directory. Remember, this is very important. You have to remember all this name. This folder is called base directory. See what is the base directory? Up to SQL Server, Microsoft SQL Server. Go to C program files and click Microsoft. This is called base directory. In base directory, you can able to see binaries and instance root directory folders. In base directory, you can able to see binaries and instance root directory folders. What is binaries? So what is binary means these two folders which are having numbers is called as binaries. I have already told you that if we install SQL Server 2000, then 80 will come. If you install SQL Server 2005, 90 folder will come. Like that, respectively, it will goes on. Like if you install SQL Server 8, 100 will come. 8R2 also 100 will come. If you install SQL Server, 100 folder will create. So if you install SQL Server 2012, 110 folder will create. Like that, so on it will goes. So we haven't installed any SQL Server 2000 here. But why we got 80 folder? We have to get only 90 folder. But here you can able to see 80 folder also. So why we get 80? See, some till 2008 8R2, even though we have installed only that particular version, generally we called this as a base version of the SQL Server, which is SQL Server 2000. So support files will be there in SQL Server 2000. So that's why some support files naming as 80. So some support files from SQL Server 2000 will came by default, even though if you install like SQL Server 2005 8R2. So that's why you can able to see this 80 folder. So this 90 folder is called as instance. So sorry, this 90 folder is called as binaries. What is the path of the binaries? Just expand this one. This is the path of the binaries. You have to make sure with these names. You have to familiar with these names. What is binaries? What is instance to directory? So the path of the up to this one base directory. So if you go to the 90 folder, that is called binaries. Then one more crucial folder, one more important folder is called instance root directories. So here if you expand, this one is called as instance root directory, mssql.1. So if you see mssql.1 or mssql as folder name, you can say it as this is a default instance. We can say it as this is a default instance. If it is named instance, how the instance root directory will be mssql dot in the place of one, you can see the name of the instance. Like if my SQL Server name is like abc, then you can able to see the instance root directory name as mssql dot abc folder. If I have installed, I have named my SQL Server as bbc, mssql dot bbc. If I named my SQL Server as xyz, mssql.xyz, like the type of folders you can able to find. If it is mssql.1, by default you can say it as it's a default instance. So if you go to this instance, you can able to see this folder, right? This is called instance root directory. Generally all files will be there in instance root directory only. All data files and log files will be there in instance root directory. So what is instance root directory? Instance root directory contains very important files. Of course all folders are important. If you remove any folder, the automatically system will, server will stop, SQL Server will stop. So but this is very crucial, like all data files, log files and error reports, errors will be there in the in this folder only. This is called instance root directory. So instance root directory, in this folder, so what are the important folders that we have to remember? So we will go into the one by one folder. Just go to 90. So you have already seen, right, what is YOLA. See COM is meant by some objects. COM objects we will call this. YOLA means some license agreement, end user's license agreement. Here one folder you can able to see, right, setup bootstrap, which is very important folder. In this folder you can able to see some files. So go to bin. So if any issue happened, while installing SQL Server, then where you can check the errors. You have come, see, these are all troubleshooting steps. If you any issue come, like while installing SQL Server, if there is any issue, we will work on issues only. Generally we will work on issues only once in a lifetime, or not once in a lifetime. Generally installation tickets will come very very rare, but you will work with regularly, you will work with troubleshooting. If any issue came, of course it has to rectify. So generally DBS will have to rectify the issue. DBS will have to clear the issue. So while installing any, while installing SQL Server, if you found any issues, then how will you troubleshoot? So if everything is goes well, if everything is goes well, then that will be tracked in the summary file. You can find this summary file. While installing SQL Server only, you can able to see the summary file. It will show if any issues are there. It will show in the summary file. This type of issue is there. This type of issue is there. Like that, you can able to show. See here 9.0.1399.06. And on OS version, what is the OS version? Server 4.0, service pack with 1. So like that, you can able to see all products here. So it will check OS. It will check machine. So it will check everything. So once everything is looks good, then only SQL Server will install. So it will note down all the paths. That's it. In summary file, you can able to see if any issue is there. You have to see the summary file only. See, setup bootstrap folder is that much important. In the setup bootstrap folder, you can able to see this one is like step by step, means part by part installation. If you found any, means it will record every step while installing SQL Server. What all registry keys has changed while installing SQL Server? What is meant by registry keys? I'll tell you later. If any, while installing SQL Server, if anything is changed in the system, it will record everything in terms of these files. So in setup bootstrap folder, you can able to see one folder called log folder. If you go to this log folder, you can able to see summary file. In the interest, they will ask, where can you see the summary file? So you have to able to answer that question. So you can able to see the log file in, you can able to see the log file in setup bootstrap folder. So this setup bootstrap folder will be very important. You have to remember this setup bootstrap folder. So in this setup bootstrap, log is very important folder. If you go there, you can able to see some summary files. So that's it for this setup bootstrap folder. I'm checking if anything I missed. So setup bootstrap folder will help like this, like that. In the setup bootstrap folder, bin n folder will be there. Bin n. In bin n folder, you can able to see some services like SQL command is one service which will help to work with SQL Server in command prompt. You can able to work with SQL Server by using command prompt also. You have to know some queries to access SQL Server by using command prompt. If you don't have SSMS, now we are having like SSMS. If you don't have SSMS, how will you check the SQL Server? How will you write queries to the SQL Server? How will you execute the queries? All will be done by with the help of SQL command, which is a tool. By using this tool, we can able to connect to the SQL Server in the command prompt, which is a black screen. So like this, some services also will be there in bin n folder. You can able to see this some services. Nothing more important than these two folders. So you have to remember this setup bootstrap, that's it. In the setup bootstrap, you have to remember that log folder. Log folder, you can able to find the summary file. And go to this, what we called as 90s called as binaries folder. Now we will call this as instance root directory. Go to instance root directory, go to MS SQL, then you can able to see some folders which are very important folders for us. So in these folders, you can able to see some binn. In this, you can able to see some DLLs, RLLs, which will support the SQL Server. See every file with the extension DLL. .dll, or else RLL, you can able to see some files like that. It will be there. So in backups, what will be there? I'll tell you. What is data folder? Data folder is very important folder for SQL Server. In that data folder, you can able to see data files and log files of every database. You can able to see. Say you can able to see like same name with two files: master master log, model model log, MSDB MSDB log, my MS SQL Server resource database logs files. Resource database file and resource database log file, tempdb and tempdb log, distribution database and distribution log. So everything will be there. So generally, if you install SQL, I'll tell you about these files later. So first we have to understand just the basics, then you can able to understand what is master, what is model. So you can able to understand these are nothing but a system databases. I have told you now, once you have installed SQL Server, you can able to see some system databases here. Here you can able to see system databases, and if you create any new database, you can able to see here ABC. If you want to create any new database, if you create any new database, you can able to see here. Just it will go down below database snapshot, you can able to see the new databases. But system database, in order to work everything perfect, we have to have someone is to be there to control the software, right? Someone is to be there to control the software. Someone is to be there to do all these things. Means while creating the data, you are writing some syntax, right? Right, you are creating some table, create table, table name, something you are writing. So on behalf of your query, who is working on your query? Who is taking care of your query? Yes, database engine only will take care, but who will help to understand all the terms? Who will control the software? So these four system databases, master, model, MSDB and tempdb, by using these four system databases, we can control the SQL Server, we can work with SQL Server, we can process the data, we can retrieve the data, we can do everything background, because of these four system databases only. If any of these four system databases is not working, so ultimately the SQL Server will not work properly. If master database is not working, SQL Server will never start. Model is also not working, SQL Server will never start. MSDB is not working, okay, somewhat we can manage, but we can't manage all the things. Tempdb is not working, SQL Server will never start. So like that, these four system databases are very crucial databases. For every database, database is a collection of two files, two default files. Database is a collection of two default files, which is a data file and a log file. Those files you can able to see here. So that's why for every database you can able to see two files here: master, master log. This is a data file, this is a log file. Model, model log. This is a data file and this is a log file. MSDB data, this is a data file and MSDB log, which is a log file. System resource, this is also one hidden database. This is also very important, but you can't able to see here. The resource database, you can't able to see here. Resource database, you can able to see only four system databases, but this will be hidden. For security purpose, they have hidden this system database. And tempdb, here you can able to see tempdb, those two files, tempdb and tempdb log, you can able to see here. So like that, you can see the size also. If we are inserting more data into the SQL Server, the size of these files will be increased. So if these files are properly working, then only SQL Server will work perfectly. Otherwise, the SQL Server will not work. So where you can find that files? MS SQL, go to instance root directory. This is called instance root directory. This is a base directory. In base directory, go to instance root directory, go to MS SQL, go to data folder. Then you can able to see all the files. If by mistake anyone removed one file, anyone deleted one file, then that's it. SQL Server will not start. It will go to stop. So like that, the data folder will helpful to see the data files and log files. So in the organization, you may not see files like this. In the organization, based upon the standards of the organization, they will distribute the files in different folders. Like they will put the data files only in one folder, they will put the log files only in another folder. Based upon their security and convenience, they will distribute the files of the databases. Don't think that if the two files are here only, that's why it is working. You can change the location of this file. You can put this master data file in any other location, but you have to mention the path in the SQL server. I'll show you where we have to mention the path. So like that we have to, like that this system databases will work. So if you go to MS SQL and if you go to the data folder, then you can able to see data files and log files. This is also one more important folder which you have to remember. Then log file. This log file contains error log, means if anything is happened in your SQL server, every step will be monitored by SQL server. Generally, if you install any software in Windows server, if anything happened in the Windows server, that will be monitored by Windows server. In the same way, SQL server also some separate log folder is there. In that log folders we can see some error log files. So this software will, by its own, it will automatically record each and every step, even though it is a error or a perfect program, even though it is anything, but it will write, at this time we have done this task, this time we have done this task, at this time this error came. Like that it will write every step to the log file. What is a log? Generally what we call it as log, if you go to any library will ask, write your name in the log file. I mean, write your name in the log. Have you write your name in the log? So like that it will, what is a log? Log file is nothing but a record. Log file is nothing but a record which will have the monitoring steps of SQL server. It will monitor everything. Like it's a camera, it will record everything. If we have done anything in SQL server, it will record everything in terms of log files. So this log folder also very important. You have to, sometimes you are unable to connect to the SQL server, you are unable to how to check that log. So you can check here, go to management, and if you go to SQL server logs, and if you expand this, if you double click on this current log, which will represent our current actions, so you can able to see everything here. You can able to see every action here, what happened from starting. So it see, just check if you are free time. Once you have installed SQL server, just check if you are free time. You may expect questions from this log file also. Like you will ask, what happened when SQL server started? Everything will be recorded in the log file. So you can able to see, you can able to remember some few points, and you can able to tell that one. So how will you track this? So first it will tag the software. So first it will track the SQL Server software and which edition it is. It will track, and again something, it will give some process IDs to some processes. So it will check everything. It will check everything is working perfectly or not. Everything, every file is there or not. It will check and it will write here. You can able to see the each and every action. So what database is starting now? Which system database will start first? So like that it will. If master database starting, it will record here. See, starting of master database. Like that you can able to, it will detect the computer name. Server name is something. This is information machine, no need to do anything. It will record if the temp DB started. Like that it will record everything. What not, you can find everything which is related to the SQL server. So like this. If the SQL server is not connecting, some issue came and you are unable to connect this log file. So if any issue came, we are unable to connect this SQL server. So then how will you check what happened in the SQL server? With the help of these folders only we can check. With the help of this error log only we can check the actions that are going in the SQL server. So like that this folder is like that much of important. This folder also we have to remember. So what folders we have to remember? Data folder, log folder. Job folders, you can able to see if any jobs are there, but now we haven't configured any job folder. So FT data, if it's a full text something kind of thing, no need to remember that much. Binen resources, and this binen I don't think So I'll tell you separately about this Binan. Nothing great is there. If anything is there, I'll cover while discussing the topic, particular topics. So these are the main folders we have to remember. What we call it as, what this folder we call it as base directory. And if you go to this base directory, you can see like binaries and instance root directory. If you go to binaries, the important folder is like setup bootstrap folder. Then you have like log folder in the setup bootstrap folder. You can able to see logs while installing SQL Server. If the installation is not successful, while installing SQL Server, if you receive any errors, you can able to see in this log folder. So like that you can able to see. And tools, if you go to tools, you can able to see some binam folder which will have some resources for the SQL Server. And if you come out from binaries, if you go to instance root directory, you can able to see like MS SQL, go to this data folder, this binam folder. You can also see services. You can able to see some services in backup folder. What is backup folder? Backup folder is nothing but just a folder if you are taking backups to a database. If you didn't mention any path, by default it will store in this backup folder. So I'll tell you, I'll explain everything while taking backups to the database. So now install, nothing is there, no problem. That has some scripts, that's it. Data and log folder are very important. So these are the folder related discussion. Now do you have any doubts? Just let me know. If you have any doubts, just let me know. Otherwise I'll continue to the next topic. So you can able to see summary file. Summary file will help to identify errors during installation. During installation, or we can check whether a SQL Server is successfully installed or not. We can find the summary file. You can find summary file in below path. Like till now this is a base directory. Go to binaries as we have discussed it now. Set up bootstrap folder and go to log folder. You can able to see some summary file. Some file extensions also we have discussed it, right? Yesterday, if all instance will take computer name as instance name, but before instance services will run with MS SQL for named instance name, databases, total number of databases. Now we are going to install SQL Server 2008 R2. Okay, once we have installed SQL Server 2008 R2, then we will discuss about some databases. Give me a minute. Now we will install SQL Server 2008 R2. We will discuss about some databases. System databases, mainly system databases. Give me a minute.